Crescio on the mic, mic controller.
Crescio back on the mic.
Right. Carnage versus Zorn. Loser gets 7.
Is this still first round of top 8?
This is.
Wow.
First losers of top 8. Not the first losers, I didn't.
Yeah.
There has been other losers.
That's just showing how stacked this tournament is, that this is first round of top 8.
Right, so this MU, I haven't actually seen it played too much, but I imagine it's sword characters are generally an issue for Peach.
Yeah.
And in this case, we have a sword and a pin.
Yep.
Which is going to be a pain to deal with from as Peach, due to having so little or no disjoints.
They're not quite getting that F smash off stage. Interesting that they'd start on the Lilat of all stages. Typically considered Karin's best stage because of all the pin shenanigans that he gets access to.
Well, if I was trying to guess Banny, obviously Zone wouldn't want to go Smashville.
Zone and would have probably banned Town and City Smashville.
FD is a bit of an issue. But for Peach, you don't really want her to go Smashville. I mean, Peach wouldn't want Karin to go Battlefield.
Yeah.
So I reckon maybe that's not bad. So, just have to see!
So I'm just allowing the grab release. Kind of trying to get spicy with the BP, but getting grab release again for it. Fair to just clear the ledge.
Whoa, a bit of a scramble at the bottom there. Literally, whoever takes this first stop,
and
that
up throw.
Yeah,
Peach does
is light enough.
The zone is sat at what could be death percent.
Lilat.
Death percent to Lilat.
Lilat it. That's the best way to go on this stage.
Yeah. And down throw just gets the damage on. Keeping Carnage.
He didn't have a jump. He actually had to fade to ledge. If he had risked up being, he could have got Lilat into it.
And Zone's up, he's just eating the turnip completely.
I was actually unsure what Zone was going to do there.
Yeah.
But I guess he just took the advantage that Peach was slow up as a slow runner.
Yeah.
Whoa.
And that's what makes this stage so good for Karin. It's just being able to pin, get the hitbox, and still get the pin.
You know, I'm looking forward there on the ledge. The next one anyway. Might take this block. Ooh, Star Sport up smash from that rolling.
And Zone just not really managing to find a way down.
Oh, that was a stitch.
Yeah.
That was a...
And forward throw. Zone managing to mash out in time.
Oh my gosh, that was so close.
Yo, okay.
I don't know what Zone's gonna do here. Uh-oh.
Back throw is gonna take the game.
Sweaty, sketchy girl. Get it. All
round it. I know, man. Everywhere I look, something needs to be done. So what we're gonna do?
So that is game one.
You know what?
Going to Carnage.
Okay, just tell him straight, innit?
Yeah, innit? I'm with you. Let's do it. Survival! Tell him straight.
Corin! Gets out there. Keep your ears open.
And no character changes going into game two. By the looks
Yo,
of it.
Remember that girl called Heather?
Don't know why either of them would switch after that.
When I say cheddar, I don't mean cash. I mean like cheese, Heather didn't have a back.
That's bullshit.
And we're going to Town and City.
Yeah, before I found out she had a book.
She's a proper skip, man. She was going on flirting.
Stage often quite liked by Peaches.
Right, so if there's no counter pick comes to Town and City, so why?
I would be interested to see why, because it is commonly considered Peach's best stage. Could be a comfort thing, it could be because Peach is quite floaty and dies off the top reasonably easily. want to take advantage of that.
And Chloe's up air does send like ridiculously far for no reason.
Yeah.
So maybe he wants to see some of those up airs come
through. Well, very risky pin, just getting him grabbed. And that up smash on the air dodge is going to take that first spot.
70%! Oh,
Peach's tip up smash is ridiculous.
That's disgusting. Holy crap, I can't believe that he killed. What the fuck is that he
And so now really on the ropes.
Oh no. I feel like he's just reaching.
Yeah. You can see just the desperation coming out in these counters as well.
Miss time spin. Ooh, wow! Pivot F smash. Very well spaced forward tilt coming out from the zone there. Really trying to pull back momentum into his side.
At 98%, Zone is already trying to fish for this kill. Down throw. Realizes up throw is not quite going to be killing yet.
Probably needs about 20 more percent.
I think it might be killing now.
Oh, wow, that back
but back air does kill now.
Okay.
And only 43% on Zone.
So despite the early up smash, he's almost even. Almost. Oh.
Down smash putting big damage onto Zone. Just dancing around each other, looking for any sort of opening. A very risky toad there from Carnage. Something very unique to Carnage's speech is his use of toad. Something you don't see too much from other features. That forward air. Poor DI, but just about surviving it. But the ledge jump air, just about surviving it. Good DI from Zone that time.
Using that platform to aid his recovery back.
Oh, Zone playing very scared, and that back air, again, not quite killing. Just maybe a little bit too stale.
I'll put it in.
And Zone now just can't get touched. Down throw. Puts Carnage up to 53%. Oh, and that kick almost killing. Zone is not out of this.
Oh, but now so well he trying is. To claw it back. This is 2-0 to Carnage right now.
And Zone staying with the current, going to Battlefield.
So it's not that Zone's horrendously outplayed. He can do it. It's just that Carnage sort of builds up the lead early game. Zone doesn't find himself leading, he always finds himself coming back.
Carnage has also been
able to get that initial momentum push. And I reckon he could take us with Zone up and then another game.
Yeah. Carnage has also been extremely efficient in getting the kills. And right now, he's just not let Zone touch him at all. That tip at F smash resets neutral.
Oh my gosh. Oh no.
Oh, and gets the toad on the upbeat, but not gonna kill.
Really, here we go, Zone again. Trying to pull his way back.
Yeah. Despite a strong start from Carnage, Zone's almost evened it up at this point.
Really, really trading Zone's disadvantage still right now. Hold in.
Yeah.
Always cover. Always cover.
Carnage had been covering it with the up smash even when Zone wasn't rolling in. The one time Zone does roll in, he gets hit by the up smash. Zone going deep. But ending up just stuck on ledge. Forward throw. Looking for the offstage spike. Up throw. Slightly too early for it to be killing. And again, Zone just pummeling.
Wow.
And this time it should.
Wow, 144?
Oh, wow.
on Battlefield, I guess.
Battlefield like, with no rage.
But
I guess.
Even still, Peach's weight still not dying. Like that.
Yeah.
That's really shocking. Oh, that grab
the Dragon Fang shot just giving zone the ledge. And up throw this time does
I
kill
have the score. Yeah, I have it already. I just have to input it.
31% on what could be zone's tournament stock.
What a strange count for that one.
All the way through the stage.
Oh. I wonder if he could have angled that upwards.
I think he could have, but he recognized the Toad was coming out and didn't want to risk it. The up smash just keeps punishing disadvantage.
Well, that's really unfortunate, the fact that Peach's back air goes through the pin forward smash.
Yeah.
And then, obviously, her back air has a lot less landing lag than the lag of the forward smash.
Yeah.
Oh no! He's being pushed right off. Zone needs to find his way back into punish. His pressure zone, but he hangs for too long.
Getting up from ledge against punish is always difficult, but Zone managing to find a grab off it. Forward throw just
this time around.
Resets the ledge situation. Zone was trying to bait out a grab roller.
He did a little dash before he dash attacked, so I reckon he was trying to make a punish into an option.
But that kick, not quite killing.
I reckon up will kill this time around with this level of rage, but there's the up air. Finally Zone taking a game back.
And Zone making sure he's not out of it at 3-0. Taking us to game 4. So we are going to Omega Pantana's Temple.
So, Omega Pantana now for game 4. So Zone shows that he can do it, it's just that he's been working way harder than Carnage has been so far in this set. It doesn't matter, but like as long as he can keep up that level of effort, I guess, he can perhaps take us to a game 5 and perhaps even close out the set for his favour.
But Zone's coming out a lot stronger in this fourth game. Already dealing big damage to Carnage, almost unanswered. And that's the first stock already in 40 seconds.
For the first time now, Zone having an extreme lead. Full stop. But Carnage, I'd say he has the best second best disadvantage state in the UK.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't count Carnage out. Zone does a good percent though.
Backdoor just sets up a ledge situation. Looking like Zone was going for a counter and didn't quite get it out in time.
That was very close space, holy
moly! Carnage almost getting lapped in percent here.
Oh wow! That was so sick!
That was insane.
Oh no! This is what TP mode looks like, everyone.
But that dash attack just sends Zone into the corner.
Oh, that was a really smart umbrella from
Zone. Yeah. Answering almost every option Zone could have had from ledge. Oh, and a very risky counter. Carnage not quite getting the stock off it. Carnage now just trying to find a way to send the stock towards...
Oh, he does manage to
smash out. Managed to smash out.
Missed the skin. Too bad. Oh, no jumps.
Pin trading with Backer.
Why does that happen? Oh my god, he tried to not again.
Backer, back row, not quite killing from center stage. So now 160%.
Wow.
Full rage. And that up throw does kill.
That game was actually played amazingly by Phil.
And we are now going to game five. From what earlier was looking like it was going to be a 3-0 in Carnage's favor.
Yeah. So looking so strong after that game. But let's see what decision making Carnage does. You know, to make sure that Zorn doesn't reverse field him.
And this is the... Is this the second or third game five we've seen in a row? 3, 2, and Carnage taking it back to Battlefield. I know you won game three here. But that doesn't matter.
I guess it's only accepted. Because the DSR is on.
Yeah. Well, it was Carnage's pick, so...
Ooh.
Oh, he doesn't have a jump. Can he make it back to the ledge? Just about.
Zone not taking any damage after half a minute now. Oh,
Zone has really adapted throughout this set. So what Carnage is doing...
Ooh!
So close to a perfect
on Zone, full stock up. Let's see the best disadvantages they come out right now.
And it's really not looking good for Carnage right now. Sitting on what could be his tournament stock.
Ooh, he went for it.
And Zone, you can just see in his play now, from what was looking kind of desperate game two, is really feeling himself right now.
Clipping the feet, his percent so low, this is so bad for Carnage right now.
And Zona's just getting really aggressive.
It's starkly in Zone's favor! Oh my god!
Zone is just staying in Carnage's face. And Carnage just doesn't have answers for it right now.
Oh, quick aerials coming up from Carnage.
Carnage finally managing to get a disadvantage state that he can take advantage of. Carnage now has to play perfectly to have any hope of staying alive in this tournament. Now looking at percents where up throw might be killing.
Again, maybe he needs about 20 more.
Potentially. Depends on how much rage affects it, to be honest.
Oh my god,
up air seals it out!
Wow.
And a clean two-stock from Zone.
That was insane. Alright, let me get the grip to the bracket. GG's.
And that game five was just pure domination. After how strong Carnage had been looking games one and two, Zone just said, I now know your game. I know what you're gonna be doing. And I don't know what game, who we're gonna be getting on next, but that set was insane. Zone just adapted so hard.